You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to borisfx.com for the premium download.
And let's do the screen right side. So one thing we can do is if we think our tracking is pretty good, we can just drop another shape into this layer and see how it works. But it's kind of hard to see this edge, so I'm going to just gain and gamma down a little bit. I'm going to hold the command key down while I slide it, just so I can see my mountain range a little bit better. And I'm going to drop a shape inside here. Click B. And create my shape. I'll probably just overlap a little bit here so there are no holes in the landscape. And some quick editing. And let's play that through. Okay, there's a little bit of drift. So we have a choice here whether I can do a new tracking layer or I can just make a few keyframes on this shape. So I think I'm just going to try to make a few keyframes and be done with it. I also noticed that my shape is not big enough. So I'll just go back to the first frame and make it a little bit bigger. And now we're going to play through, scrub through, we'll go to the last frame, and I can see that it's a little bit off. And how I'm going to check that is I'm going to just make a placeholder keyframe. And how I do that is I click Alt in the timeline. So I'm on my spline 2. And now you can see I have a keyframe, and I can go from Shift Z, the first keyframe, to the next keyframe, Shift X. So I can see I need to edit my shape a little bit to move it up. I'm going to press the T for the transform and just nudge it up with the arrow keys. And I'll toggle back and forth with Shift Z, Shift X, and we're pretty locked on. I'll click the R key to get out of transform. And maybe I'll make a keyframe in the middle. It looks like there's a little bit of movement there. And at this point, I'm realizing if I have to make one more keyframe, I might as well just make a new layer for tracking. So I'll click T for the transform mode. And that looks pretty good. And this point, we can probably just press 4 for the color comp, turn off the overlays, and see what this looks like. So I can still see a little movement here. It's still caching through. So what might be best is if we do a new tracking layer for this screen right side. I'm going to stop with the playback, go back to output. So I'm going to delete this shape here, which is the spline 2, which is the screen right side. We'll turn on our overlays by clicking the viewer, and we'll just delete that. Okay, let's make a track for the screen right side, and this time we'll use the planar tracker, the Mocha planar tracker. I'm going to lock my shape here, and we will go to the Roto node, click Shift T, and go to the Mocha tracker. I'm going to get out of the stabilized view, and now we just have our normal view, which is not stabilized. The Mocha tracker is a planar tracker that does not use the traditional point trackers, but instead uses roto shapes defined by the artist. One looks for planes to track, which could be any flat surface having only two dimensions. Planar tracking can capture an object's translation, rotation, and scaling, plus shearing and perspective if needed. So I'm going to use a rectangle here, Shift S, and I'm going to put my shape right there, and we're going to track that. So let's go to the tracker again, Shift T, and now we're in the Mocha tracker. So in this case, I'm just going to track translation. I don't think there's a lot of scaling or rotation, and this will be a fast way to go. I can even go to the foreground mode here and track. And we'll track the rest of the shot. I'm going to click on the timeline, and I can see here that I need to track back to the beginning. Okay, you can see that the camera lens moved through our shape. And it may affect our track, or it might not. Sometimes if something just moves briefly through, it doesn't really matter. So we're going to name our layer, Screen Right Mountain. And this is our tracker. I tend to name my trackers TRK, and I like to make them green. And then I turn them off. Some people delete their tracks, but I keep them because if the frame range of your shot changes, you want to be able to use the same shape to track forwards or backwards. So let's find our landscape where it's most of it is in frame. You just make one shape for this area. Okay, I think I'll make my shape around here. Click B for B spline. Zoom in here and do some editing. Okay, then let's play this through and see how our shape looks. Okay, that's pretty locked. So I think it was a better idea to make a new track, but it's always good to try to see if you can reuse the tracking data that you have. And to look at this in the stabilized view for a little extra QC, we'll go to Screen Right Mountain and play again. Right, so the planar tracker was a good option for that side.